What to eat in Marseille, the most underrated city in Europe Part 2. Iola. Many people mistake Iola as any flavored mayonnaise, but that's not really quite true. In Marseille, Iola is made with garlic, lemon juice, eggs and olive oil. But it's not simply a dipping sauce for frites. The dish to order is Iola Provençale Complète. It's a plate of salt cod, steamed vegetables and shellfish, all to be dipped in Iola. If you're like me and love dip as a general food category, then this is the plate for you. Traditional Provençal restaurants serve this dish on Fridays, and both Bistro Petit Saint Louis or Babalivo restaurant are often recommended. Tapenade. You have likely tried this puree made from capers, anchovies, black olives, garlic and olive oil. In Marseille, locals enjoy it with an apéritif with croutons or crostini. It's also quite inexpensive at the grocery store and makes for a great souvenir. Panis. As soon as I heard about panis, I immediately thought of farinata, the Italian chickpea flatbread / pancake. Although I had it as the bread or a fish sandwich, it's more common for it to be rolled into a log and cut into coins than fried. They are a great snack or side dish. Sometimes they are tossed in sugar, but they can also be savory and pair perfectly with the local cassis wine. Pastis. Italy has its spritz for aperitif hour, but the south of France is all about the pastis. In 1932, industrialist Paul Richard invented this anise-flavored aperitif, which would replace a freshly banned absinthe. Available in every bar, its strong flavor is diluted by water, 1/3 pastis to 2/3 water. Although he most well-known brands are 51 and Pernod Richard, you can also find artisanal brands like Pastis Ginot and La Maison du Pastis. Seafood. The Mediterranean is full of delicious sea urchins, escargot, shrimp, crabs, and oysters. For a seafood feast, check out Toenou in the city center. Pizza. Yes. I said pizza. If you ask locals what to eat in Marseille, they are going to say pizza. Marseille claims to have invented the wood-fired pizza oven or au feu de bois long before Italy. IR seems peculiar at first, but Marseille is a city of immigrants, many of them from Corsica and Italy, especially Naples. You'll find a strong Italian influence here because of its proximity to Italy. One of the most famous Marseille pizzas is at Chez Etienne, and there's also a number of pizza trucks like Le Safari. But we ate at La Bonne Mire, which is getting buzz as the newest best pizza in Marseille. I'm not sure if it's the best, but I will say this is a real neighborhood restaurant. You'll sit next to families that go every week. Staff are incredibly friendly with advice like, dough is like a woman, the more attention you give it, the more it will give back to you. They refuse to use a rolling pin as it ruins fermentation in the dough, all those bubbles are where the food flavor rests. But don't expect this to be authentic Neapolitan pizza. It's somewhere between Naples and Rome, and with more sauce and toppings because that's the local preference. Craft beer. France is an emerging hub for craft beer. Local brewers will be the first to say they have much to learn from Canada and America. Drinking craft beer is a great way to learn more about local products. For example, Beer de la Plaine is collaborating with other local craft brewers to grow their own hops regionally. You can find craft beer at local restaurants, and it's a great souvenir for someone who doesn't like wine. Pizzolatiere. Perhaps the best way to describe a pizzolatiere is somewhere between a pizza and a puff pastry tart. It is traditionally made with onions, anchovies, and black olives with a light tart crust. Pides et packets. I cannot resist offal. Pides et packets, translated to feet and tripe. For this I need to find a very local restaurant where I stayed. Normally a hotel wouldn't be so important in a list of local food, but I loved the location of La Résidence du Vieux Port Marseilles. It has an amazing view as it's centrally located in the old port, across the street from the weekly fish market. Thank you. Although I'll need to return to learn what to eat in Marseille, I'm so thankful for the opportunity to visit Provence, even the short time. Thank you to Air France for the flight to Paris and the generous business class upgrade on the return flight home. What a treat to sleep lying down. to Rail Europe for the train tickets within France and the beautiful views to Provence. To my web spot for Wi-Fi throughout the trip. You made a believer out of me. While I usually just buy a local SIM card, this was so much easier. And finally to Etout France and the city and regional tourism boards that planned the itinerary. You reminded me of why I fell in love with France over 20 years ago.